It is the 1st of February, and this is part two of the five-year-old Christ is like a WWE SmackDown. Is that what you've heard so far? Because this is a part two.
That's what I heard so far.
And if people don't know what we're talking about, go back and watch part one. It's available everywhere. It's available. Wait. Hey, producer lady, I'm trying to show off.
It will be available shortly. Just know that.
Hey, I'm gonna get in trouble here. We're gonna be live on Rumble and on Twitter in real time with our news feed in the next couple of days. And everyone on my team said, oh my God.
Yeah.
So, hey, look, Gandalf's everywhere, man. Gandalf's everywhere, man. Oh, wait.
And he's in the mountains, guys. So, you know.
And this is all the places we are. If I'm doing this right, and the thing that's recorded, but not in one, I don't know. There's too many things going on for me to keep track, which is a significant number of things. Oh, wait. It's because I don't give a shit. So when we last left our hero, who is a... Okay, so anyone who didn't see the first one, and they're about to give up. Don't. Well, don't. Brandy, catch us up. Where did we start? All of episode one in 10 seconds. Could you do that?
Can I what?
Can you recap all of episode one in 10 seconds?
I don't think so.
I can name that recap in how many seconds?
1/2 second. Jesus wow. Christ.
Oh, man, you cheated. That's like saying shortest scripture, Jesus wept. Two words. Come on. Everybody knows that one. Okay, so would you like, can I help you here?
Sure.
When we last left our hero, young Christ, the five-year-old was kicking everyone's asses to the point where he even says, this is five-year-old Christ. He says to the teachers, hey, the first letter of the alphabet, which is described as Aleph, not even Alpha. Look at that. What's the first thing I do when I want to make something hard to find?
Change the name.
So Alpha is A-L-P-H-A. So if I'm going to rationalize, well, they should have seen it. I only changed it by one. You know, every dyslexic child sees that as Alpha. Okay. A-L-P-H is Alpha. Alpha and Omega. Oh, Omega turned into Tau. Tau is Tao. Tao is Taoistic. Taoistic is rabbit hole. Oh, hypocrites. These are Pharisees. I can do this all day, but I only have 46 minutes left until I start getting yelled at. So what? Well, oh, wait, I'm going to go down here because five-year-old, well, he might be four. No, he's five. He's five. But by this time, he's five. And he says about the first letter of the Greek alphabet, I go back to Greek, base 8, base 10, base 12. You can even go to base 16, which is hexadecimal, all the way to the top end of the programming languages. So what, triangles, scalene, acute angle, equilateral, unequal sided, unequal angles, rectangular, rectilinear, and curvilinear. Did you know that rectilinear and curvilinear are actually more about physics than they are about basic math? And five-year-old Christ, he is on it. He's in there like swimwear. Way up inside of the crack of it, right? I got away with that without getting slapped? Okay. So now they tell you why they changed the letters. Instead of tau, the Latin text reads tet. What do I want to do? If I want to make something really hard to understand, find, or research, what do I do every single time, Brandy? Every single time.
Change the name.
Okay, so I know you hate it when I do this to you. I'm going to put you on the spot. I want you to start over here in subset 1.3. So the thing up here they're referring is the center of the alphabet. How hard is it to research a thing if you don't know the alphabet?
It's a little difficult.
Well, you have to. Well, you have to be a wizard. Okay, so look, let's look at a very. This text is from the early 1800s, like less than 1825. Okay, so and it's all of the apocryphal scriptures before they got erased. This is one of the last. This is the most strident representation of this text I have find, and that took me. It took me close to 20 years, actually. So that's why I tend to spend a little time here. Read three to me.
Number three,
the words in the original. Okay, they're referring to a thing that is a difference of the Latin and it instead of. So I'm already three layers deep. And here is the Latin reference to the original part of the text. This 11-word stratus, you're going to, well, 18 if you start over there and end at R, that you're going to read right now is the way I found this text. It was mediatos, by the way, the ninth word that really got me here. You remember when I found this text? It was like, holy shit, I think I found it.
Yeah, you did.
If my Latin was just a little bit worse, I wouldn't have found it. So I know you're not. That's why I'm trying to make a point here. So take a breath and do this in the right rhythm, because I believe you can do this. Imagine that you are an elitist waiter in an Italian restaurant in the middle of Sicily, and I've dragged you to a place where no one speaks English, and I'm trying to use my broken Spanglish and just flash a bunch of money, and you have to read the menu. Not that would ever happen.
That has happened more than once.
You know, Mallorca is fantastic in the spring. Okay, go ahead. Read me the original words.
The words in the original are gratuitos, subacutus, mediotus, ductus, productus, erectos, stratos, curvus, stratos. I feel like I'm speaking Pig Latin.
Okay, now hold on. Ik pe atle is ye a ifrit day English way. U de atne otre, ik pe atle and ye atne, expect ye in a e sponsre in ye ik pe atle. So I want you to do this again, and I want you to really put on your Italian waiter. Imagine each one of these is imagine each one of those words is a really good tasting food. Do it again.
The words in the original are gradatos.
I don't want to eat gradatos. Gradatos.
I told you I'm not Italian.
Come on. Cool ass. Do not tell me you can't know Cajun slur. So it's also a romantic language. I'm trying to help everyone else by putting you on the spot. I know I'm going to get yelled at this for this later, and Sassy is absolutely going to yell.
You got me laughing my butt off. Okay.
Stop looking for the camera. It's inside your head. The words in the original are gradatos, subcutas, that's subcutaneous, by the way, mediatos, or mediator, obscutus or obfuscation, productos. As used to productos, the fungal, student of the bache. My Italian is not that good. Productos, erectos, stratos, curvis stratos. Because even stratos, no, stratos is stratosphere. That is a description of the dome in the original. There was firmament and there was stratos. The erectus of the stratos is the productos of the obstructos, which is the observation of us.
I would have never got that the way you did. Sorry.
Well, your Latin's not good enough. Well, we are by no means, and I will thank my earthly father for the fact that my Latin exists. Not even that it doesn't really look. My Latin is equivalent to frio cerveza five times, and then donde está baño? which is give me five beers and then tell me where the bathroom is. We are by no means confident that the terms we have given are the equivalents of these. This is all a footnote. And up here is the references to the 66-book Bible as it was produced in about, I'm guessing this is, I can't remember this exact version of this text. I think it's 1816. I know they're all from the same publisher. But the Bible was rewritten in 1243 and then once again in 1262 by the same guy. And he worked for the king. Oh, what's it called? The King James Version? I'm not going to do anybody else's research. Okay. Okay, we're recording. 10:45. Okay, so look. When we last left young Jesus. Oh, wait. Jesus is smiling. Let's go back. He killed someone right before this, I swear. I found my master, now wretched, before the flood. Okay, here's where we are. Oh, it's right near my footnote. Let's start at a paragraph. Oh, this is Zacchaeus asking about why did you put this child upon me? That is home alone, like times a million. Oh, this is where we left our story. Would you like to pick up?
Right.
You know, Brandy, you're supposed to keep me from railing before I even start.
Well, find your place.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Quit watching the camera and looking at me.
Okay. There's a 6'8" human that if he ever hears that knows that that's me saying, okay, yes, ma'am, I understand. I did not miss and move in my Rocket League game. Okay. I flee before him. So this is Zacchaeus, who is the teacher of, what's his name? It's not Elijah. It's Ezra. It's, Levi. There's a whole tribe named after Levi, right? I can find that all over the 66-book Bible. So the guy that taught Levi is saying this about a five-year-old Christ. Because Christ was sent to Levi, which they're defining again down here by renaming everything. Because Christ just says, hey, you want me to solve all the math for you? So the five-year-old Christ, and Levi hears this, and he's like, this is above my pay grade. So he is reaching out to Zacchaeus saying, look, here's what just happened in my life. In the hearing of all, I cried out, and I said, how does this kid exist? He doesn't deserve the hanging on the cross he's going to get. Christ is five. Oh, this is where I left off. For he can extinguish fire. He can mock others. He can torment. He was before the flood, before the deluge. If you don't know about the flood, hey, Brandy, have we done a couple of flood shows?
Yes, we have done quite a few.
A show maybe 7 shows ago. That was actual footage from the flood in 1892 in Paris. That was fun.
Not at the time, but he means it was fun to watch the pictures.
I remember that you cut me off with a very stern finger in 1 hour and 4 minutes.
That's true, I did.
I think it was 7 shows ago. Okay. I flee before him. I can't endure the world in his mouth. This is Levi, the leader of the tribe of Levi. Oh, the name of the guy the tribe is named after, because it's called the tribe of Levi. The voice right now is Levi. And they don't want you to find this name so much, they made a gene company. Do not let me go down this rail, please. This will never take less than 5 hours. I am a keyword specialist, and there's stuff I look for, and I'm like, video game. Oh, you've watched this. I think no man can attain to his word except God, who's been with him, blah, 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 blah. Let's get this for fireworks. Oh, Jesus responds to all this, Levi going, wait, wait, wait. Hey, have you called wine 1-1? You know, the wambulance?
Yeah.
Hey, Brandy, what sound does the wambulance make?
Wah,
wah. Oh, studio audience, you can do better than that. What sound does the wambulance make? Way, 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 wait, on your phone? Oh, wait, it's not on your phone. It's probably on a walk with someone you care about. Maybe it's your dog. Grab the peanut butter. Have a new relationship with your animal. Okay. And Jesus says, what the fuck? I got the studio audience to laugh. They didn't have very often. Okay. And Jesus says, when the pleasant count is smiling. Wow, a dog will do that with peanut butter? No, that's not what he said. He says with a command, as all of the children of Israel stood by and heard, let the unfruitful be fruitful, let the blind see, let the lame walk. What? Are these all the promises of God in the 66 book version? Yeah, yeah, Christ is 5-year-old, goes in high. Wait, 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 wait. Do you think it would be noteworthy in the 66-book version of the Bible to maybe remind people that when Christ was 5, he went around healing people?
It would be very good to remind everyone.
It happened that one of the children pushed another off the roof on the ground. He died. Although the parents of the deceased had not seen it, they cried against Joseph and Mary, saying, your son hath thrust our... Man, I've gone like 20 pages down. Baby Jesus is hard to manage. He's a tough babysit. he just keeps... Man, okay, so you're the mother of the kid who just got pushed off the roof by Jesus. I think this is the Damien, right? I think Damien the Omen pushes... No, I'm not going to do it. I can't get lost. Okay,
yeah,
so like, there's a movie clip where Damien the Omen, first produced in 1972... remade recently within the last 3 years. It's about an infested child with a spirit from another world. Where so they're already building that narrative. I could get lost there for a half an hour, but producer lady's gonna yell at me. So your son pushed our son off the roof and he's dead, but Jesus is silent. He says nothing. Do you know when you say nothing at the card table, you are either bluffing, or you know you're going to win.
That's
just say. now, una sabiti. Oh, the one who can rise. Oh, well, thank you, Dad. I appreciate the ladder. Okay, Jesus was silent. He answers him, nothing. And now Joseph and Mary come in haste and say, oh, Jesus. And his mother asks him, saying, hey, now, Jesus is 5. And his mother addresses him as what? My Lord. I have a son who's taller than me. And when he was 5, I was telling him, hey, if they pull you over, I'll tell you you're 9 because you're not going to fit in the car seat anymore.
I had the same problem.
Well, that's a lie. He was 3. And he was already bigger than when he would have been 6 by normal human standpoints. But, you know, my offspring are not normal. Okay. My Lord, tell me, trust him in the ground immediately. Blah, blah, blah. Okay. So Jesus comes down from the roof and he calls the boy. His name's Zeno. If you're my child and you bring your friend Zeno in the house, I'm immediately going to hide my weed. So he answers him, hey Lord, Jesus is 5. How often do you call a 5-year-old Lord? Wait, I'm gonna do it. either going to get this in one click or I'm going to get nothing. Oh, I think I did it. Okay, so normally, if you're going to call people a god, you get something that looks more like this.
Are you a god?
Oh, wait. They start off right with it. Hopefully the audio is good. If someone asks you if you're a god, it looks more like this. This is no one here is 5 years old. And I really don't think anybody's human, but that's beside the point. What do you do? You say,
are you a god?
In a demonic voice, are you a god? The humans, wait, no one's 5 years old here.
No.
No, it's the wrong answer. That is the wrong answer. If you are approached and asked,
are you a god?
No.
That is not the right answer. Oh wait, do we get this Dave Frosty Man guy? Do we get him? Oh yeah, here he comes.
This looks extraordinarily bad.
Oh no.
What?
So this is the fear of, they asked you if you were a god, you said no. And then you were thought, maybe you had a random thought that might be something from your pineal gland. Oh, I'm so happy. The RV is here. We're in the age of Aquarius. We've won. It was just a movie. We've neutralized it.
Neutralized it. You know what that means? A complete particle reversal.
We have the tools. We have.
Oh, wait. He even called it another name. Oh, it must be right. You know what that means?
You know what that means? A complete particle reversal.
A particle reversal? Wait, maybe that's Aquarian.
We have the tools. We have talent.
Yeah, but we work together as a team. I got a Jew. I got a black guy. And I got two, mudbloods. All these people were on Saturday Night Live, by the way.
It's Miller time.
Oh, ready? Yeah, gotta buy a product.
Tools.
We have the tools, we have the talent. We won. It's Miller and then time. Buy a branded beer.
Ray, this looks extraordinarily bad.
Oh, no.
Oh, wait. We can't have any more good times because we just had a good time. So Brandy, what is that? Is that a flood? Is that an earthquake? Is that a rain event? Is that, am I forgetting anything?
Tornadoes.
Oh, damn. How could I forget the tornado? Dorothy.
Nice.
Okay, so we just had an event where everyone said, yay, it's Miller time. We're winning. No, it looks extraordinarily bad.
What?
Oh, don't look up away from my phone. It's an event in the sky that might be a holograph. What was that, 5 shows ago?
That's right.
I would go pull up the holograph show, but I'm running out of minutes.
That you are.
Look out!
And there will be ships hidden within the holographs that make tactile feedback, like gestation or moving. And all that Tartarian technology, that's got to come down, doesn't it?
It does.
So earlier in the movie, they go through the fact that this building is some ancient piece of technology that is tuned to be the only available gateway for this event. And if I'm spoilering you, then oh my God, you're the first cryogenic guy to come back and actually have a brain that we know about. Because this was published, I don't even think I had my first midlife crisis when it was published. You're supposed to laugh at me and not near me. Oh, wait, the other way around. Scare of it. Scare of it.
The creature's
goals have gone the area. You know, are you there, Brandy?
I am.
Okay.
I have something for you when you're ready.
Okay, so wait a minute. I want to make fun of the names. Gozer the Gozerian. So if I'm in a meeting with a bunch of marketing people, right? And I say, okay, come on, team. Let's get it done. I need a name that's going to hit like Just Do It, right? It's going to be the Harry Potter of wizardry around names. I don't think Gozer the Gozerian is very, you know... I mean, you use the same word twice. There's only three letters different. It's Gozer the Gozer with a, oh, give it an Aryan. As we get the program, oh, look at these guys. I think they're afraid of Gozer the Gozerian. If they ask you if you're a god, you say yes. You know why? If they ask you if you're a god, Brandy, do you know why you say yes? Do you know why?
Because there can only be one.
There can be only one.
Bam! That's all your perceptions of who you... We have been lied to about who we are, what we are, when we are, and what we're capable of. Look how many pieces there are to this. Big Pharma, I need to stop right now or I'm going to get yelled at.
Okay, you're about to get yelled at. Can you
read this? A million things. A million things are bullshit, okay? That is the entire Gandalph message. Oh, Gozer the Gozerian. That's pretty simple. My message is never simple. Oh, and I talk too fast. I talk too fast all the time because I can.
I have a message for you to read.
Wait, a moment.
Okay, tell me
when
you're ready.
Yes, ma'am, one moment, please. Yes, ma'am, one moment.
Gozer the Destructor, Volga Sildor, the Traveler has come. Choose and perish.
What do you mean, choose? We don't understand.
Choose the form of...
Okay, so this is a Tartarian building. It's in the middle of an energy event. This was a very popular movie when it came out. I remember this. I actually went to see this movie at a drive-in one time. Not far from where I'm sitting right now, actually. So, anyway, Gozer the Gozerian, choose a form. Choose. Piscean choice, Aquarian not choice.
The Destructor.
Oh, damn it. We don't get to see it? Oh, no, I can't live with that. No. We have to see it. We have to see because... Blood figures. So Gozer says, choose a form. Choose a form. Oh, let's do this one.
Ray.
So... The other one was the right one. Because we already see him. It's right here. So they say, Ray, choose.
This looks extraordinarily bad.
Ray. Here we go. This is what happens when you choose. You can't make a good choice, like saying nothing, taking a nap. Hey, Brandy, what do you do when you're in doubt?
There's two things. Shut up or take a nap.
I think it's hard to talk while you're asleep, so they're the same thing. So here's what happens when you open your mouth. Hey, yeah, it's great. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Immediately it is.
Hey, this looks extraordinarily bad.
Oh, no.
What?
That is very Tartarian. Look at that. That's the receiving for the energy. This is a conduit to an alternate universe or... Well, go watch the movie. I'll spoil the whole thing if I can.
Look out!
Subhuman, useless eaters, you are under the tyranny of the WHO because we voted your rights away with the vote you thought counted by Gozer the Gozerian, who is politician chosen.
Volga Sildroha, the traveler.
Oh, the traveler has come. It's Joe Biden with the WHO, and you'll do whatever we want.
Has come. Choose and perish.
What do you mean, choose?
What do you mean, choose? I only get two options. Two options.
Choose and perish.
What? Choose and perish? Not choose or. Choose and. Choose and perish. No matter what comes for the and, that's an and else statement in the programming universe. Choose and you're done. Oh, wait. We got to choose. You'll love this. The choosing is perfect. Hey, Brandy, are we in the time of choosing?
We are.
So I'm trying to give you all the components that you need to choose something else, because I'm not a red pill or a blue pill guy. I'm a
no pill guy.
So at this point, I think I pretty much sit down and get a PB&J, which is a Pabst Blue Ribbon and a shot of a Jameson.
What do you mean, choose?
I'm going to go to the bar right now. You guys can watch the rest of this. I'll be back in a minute.
What do you mean, choose? We don't understand.
Choose. Choose the form of the destructor.
Oh, I get it. Oh, very cute. Whatever we think of. If we think of J. Edgar Hoover, J. Edgar Hoover will appear and destroy us, okay? So empty your heads. Empty your heads. Don't think of anything. We've only got one shot at this.
The choice is made.
Whoa!
The traveler has come.
Nobody choose anything. Did you choose anything?
No.
Did you?
My mind is totally blank.
I didn't choose anything.
This character's name is Vinkman, by the way, and I'm obviously Bill Murray in this scene, and Brandy, I'm sorry, honey, this is you. No, I. This probably is the meanest thing I've ever done to you on air, but in our team, you care enough to actually think of something where you would say, I will fix this and think of something that can't be horrible. At the end of that chain is failed expectation. So I just want to point this out. This guy is proving my failed expectation theory model, because look at this face. He's like, oh, are you fucking kidding me? That Gandalf told me what to do and I thought I could do it just a little bit better. And now, well, we have to work together as a team or we're all going to die. So, honey, I love you, and you do so many things to support me. Vinkman, this guy can't be this without this person here, and that is you on our team, and I appreciate you. But you still thought of the marshmallow man.
Yeah, you may change your mind in a few minutes. Let me know when you're ready. I have something to say.
I can help it. It just popped in. I couldn't help it. It just popped in there. I couldn't help it. It just popped in there.
What? What just popped in?
We've had that phone call more than once.
In there. I tried to think.
Look!
No! It can't.
That's Justin.
What? I tried to think.
Look!
What just popped in there? I tried to think.
He even looks a little bit like Justin, doesn't he? For those that don't know my entire team, which is most every ball of humanity, we have a programmer who is a fantastic human, and he could resemble this guy. So Justin says, holy crap, Brandy changed their credential.
No, it can't be. What is it? It can't be.
What did you do, Ray?
Oh, shit.
It's the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man.
So in my analogy, I'm trying to drive home here and spending precious minutes against my 54-minute clock. I'm trying to say that when you wake up, so we have some scripture I'm going to get back to here in just a minute and bring this back. I'm trying to tell a story of Christ when he was 5 years old. And you have, well, I did once upon a time, before I found the scripture, I thought that Christ was, I'm just missing 26 years of the first account of him. The guy I'm supposed to follow and say is living within me. That's the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man. It's a thing I had that was a description. And the enemy has used this in every movie and every book and every piece of thing. I don't trust anything before the 12th century. And I really like 7 years old. Because this is Christ wrapped in a wrapper coming in all of us. Oh, my God. I couldn't believe it. I encountered a God, and I turned out my God looked good but wanted to kill me. Because I'm a sinner, because I can't live in the middle of it, because there's guilt and there's rage, and that's all bullshit. So, Brandy, this is a fear of it. Do you see it?
I do.
This next scene, put a couple of words in the middle of this dialogue. I don't need to go ahead. I know every second of this film. Wait, I have a different memory. Oh, can I teach you how to do that? Yeah. Start with the lesson of three voices. Go there first. Okay, so look, what is going to happen is the dialogue of the people on the roof that are about to battle a thing. This is called dissonance. It's happening in real time. So the dissonance of those that realize they have to battle a thought in their own mind. That's what's playing out here. That's the program. This is the face of a thought you thought you could never have, and when you started thinking about it, it broke your head.
Well, there's something you don't see every day.
Yeah, something. I tried to think of a harmless thing like voter fraud or apocryphal scripture.
The most harmless thing, something I loved from my childhood, something that could never, ever possibly destroy us.
Something that could never, ever possibly be bad. Child Protective Services, the IRS.
Mr. Stay Puft.
Nice thinking, Ray.
We used to roast Stay Puft marshmallows.
Oh, I don't know. When I was a kid, the government agency came to my house and gave me support services. They can't be bad.
By the fire at Camp Wakanda.
Ray has gone bye-bye, Egon. What have you got left?
Okay. These are the two guys who are still in the fight. Brandy, I've had to pull you out by the heart of your rooted hair more than once and say, hey, look, this is like someone went bye-bye us. I've all you got left. What can we do this? Is it pleasant when I do that?
No, it's not.
Okay. Someone in your life has to do that, or you have to be the person. But one of you's got to do it. One of you got you want to get the thing next that happens? Everyone's got to come together. Go listen to SGN on. Go listen to whoever. Stop listening and do. Oh, this is an environment we're going to have to do something. This is the scare event. Everyone's going to get challenged.
Sorry, Beckman. I'm terrified beyond the capacity for rational thought.
Wait. Will you please read the caption?
Sorry, Vinkman. I'm terrified beyond the capacity for rational thought.
Does that sound like a scare of it?
It does, doesn't it?
I'm terrified beyond the capacity for rational thought.
Look at all the terror. Oh, I'm scared. Oh my God, they did it. Look, they even show the media. Fake news right here. Right there. Fake news protected by an Antifa helmet and cop. You know, this movie's from the 80s, right?
I never could watch this movie.
Probably because you were going, oh, mother pus bucket. I don't like this movie.
Good.
I think that's what all the patriots are saying right now, right?
Yep. Couldn't handle the fear porn.
Oh, no. Mother pus bucket.
Nobody steps on a church in my town.
I could go pull up the a Q post in a Trump action to support this statement. Hollywood's been programming us for a long time, people. What's my opinion about all the information we've gotten thus far, Brandy? What have we been lied to about?
Everything, and I could have put a word in between that. You might know where I was going to go.
I think friggin'.
Sounds good. We'll go with that.
I'm listening. I'm listening, Sassy, okay? And I'm not mad at you, honey. I'm just busy.
One, two, three.
This is the Patriots standing up. Let's talk about how we get there. That's a pretty rocky transition. I should probably work on that.
Yeah. So could you give me a second?
1001. Yes. So
you are
now
going
Jesus
to...
is six.
Yeah, really? Jesus. Can you read?
Will you please do the commercial?
Yeah, sure. Sponsored by Anti-Aging Bed, 1-800-385-4243. And just to let you know, we are on YouTube and we have sauces at Anti-Aging Beds. Give them a call. All right. At least the boss is not calling me.
So you know what? The boss is going to call me because I was specifically told to stop pushing sauces.
Oh, wow.
Oh, no, I just love the fact that that happened in real time.
Yeah.
Gandalph will pick up the entire sauce business should that happen. I'm not bullshitting. I have a local partner. Okay, so I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're at 44 minutes, so I want to get through. We're on page 192 of the PDF, and I think we need a part three.
I think you're right.
Will you ask how many? What do we have? One person left? Seven. I love seven. Biblical number. So ask the studio audience, otherwise known as Twitch. The studio audience can be a million people, by the way, if people actually follow me on Twitch. But I am the most annoying human ever to follow on Twitch on purpose. So should I do like a teaser?
Sure. And then,
or should I get into that? I mean, look, I've shown you a pattern so far that Jesus is an excellent daycare terrorist. I mean, look, I say that in the most loving way because he's not really a terrorist because he always brings them all back. But man, you want to talk about pissing people off, you know, going through the grief to return cycle of killing your kid for 5 or 6 hours. I don't know. I think it's good television.
That's a possibility.
Well, so you want me to give you like a couple of minutes of 6-year-old Jesus before we move on?
Yes. Yeah.
You tell me it's on the screen. You tell me it's on the screen.
Now, Jesus was 6 years old, and his mother sent him with a pitcher to the fountain to draw water with the children. And it came to pass after he drew the water that one of the children trussed against him and shattered the pitcher and broke it.
Okay, so hold on. What I just heard you say is that I sent a 6-year-old with a bucket to go get some water and bring it home, but the bucket was sort of fragile, and the two kids just sort of bumped into each other, and the pitcher broke. Is that what you said?
That's what I just said.
Okay, well, I'm going to tell you. You want to talk about Home Alone 2? let's see what Jesus does. Try to draw the water with him, pitcher. Okay, keep going.
But Jesus spread out the cloak, which he wore, and took in his cloak as much water as there was in the pitcher, and carried it to his mother. And she marveled when she saw it, and thought within herself,
oh, hold on. Your screen shifted. Let me go back and cover you for a second here. Now Jesus is 6 years old. His mother sends him with a pitcher to the fountain. So go get some water, boy. Okay, that's the command. Now you remember that Jesus has already proven that if you piss him off, your day is going to get strange. We didn't even get to the story about Jesus turning his friend into a frog. One of the later pestilences. Anyway, and it came to pass after he drew the water that one of the children thrust against him and shatters the pitcher. So, oh, boom, I bumped you in the shoulder. Sorry, bro. Oh, no, sorry, bro. Here, Jesus spreads his cloak out and he took in his cloak as much water as there was in the pitcher and he carries it to his mother. Jesus finishes his task and she marvels. She sees it because his cloak has carried the water. It's a cloak. This is not a millennia level technology device. It's some Tony Stark Iron Man auto holding structure. It's his freaking jacket. Actually, it's his cape, to be more specific in current vernacular. And she marvels when she saw it, and she wrought within herself and laid up all these things in her heart. Okay, so Jesus is 6. And now, rather than killing the kid, he just solves the problem. So we're going to do some Jesus from maybe 6 through, how far are we going? I'm finishing on page 192 of the PDF. If you want the PDF, go to Locals. Hey, Brandy, will you please just talk about all the platforms for a second?
Sure. We have CloudHub, Rumble, BitChute, Brighteon, and we have Minds, Getter, Gab, and Truth Social. And then we have Facebook, Twitch, and YouTube.
I think you got them all. You better watch out. You're getting pretty darn good at this. And if I have not told you lately, I appreciate you.
Thank you.
So we'll go on. You know what this looks like? Everyone in the Twitchverse, my goal is to be the most frustrating human to watch ever. I never record anything on Twitch. It's always live. So become a member, follow, you'll get an email. Have a nice day. Then I just cut Twitch because Harrison started with, oh wait, we're still recording. Okay, so say goodnight, Gracie.